Jeffrey asks us, can toilet seat covers they have in public restrooms stop you from getting an STD from toilet seats someone who had one sat on? Flimsy white sheets shaped like the seat, and that was a massive tongue twister. Paper toilet liners can be found in many public bathrooms. Notably, however, while they may provide reassurance to the germaphobic and finicky, toilet seat covers have little else to offer in terms of decreasing your odds of being infected with some pathogen when sitting on the toilet seat. Once thought to be capable of conducting sexually transmitted diseases, STDs, contrary to popular belief, today scientists know that toilet seats are very poor vehicles for spreading such maladies like herpes and HIV. This is due to the relative fragility of these viruses outside of a human host, as well as the very effective protective barrier offered by the skin of your backside. Note, however, that if you do have an open cut or other open wounds on your derriere, it is possible one of these viruses could get in through that scenario. Of course, this doesn't mean that viruses and bacteria aren't sometimes present on the toilet seats, and in fact, one particularly unlucky 8-year-old Australian girl, whose name was not disclosed in the report, got gonorrhea from one. However, she didn't get it by sitting on the seat. She actually picked it up when she tried to use toilet paper to clean the soiled seat and got the microbes on her hands. In addition to a few short-lived STDs, toilet seats may have germs like E. coli and Streptococcus. However, neither of these can typically invade a body through the skin, so the only way they will make you sick is if they get on your hands and then you don't wash your hands before eating something or the like. Nonetheless, some people have very sensitive skin, and seats covered with certain allergy triggers like chemical cleaners, paints, or varnishes may cause contact dermatitis, a condition seat covers would certainly help prevent. In addition, the truly fastidious would find themselves in a difficult position if the toilet seat liners weren't available. For the biggest germaphobes, toilet paper strategically placed on top of the toilet seat liner may also ease your mind, albeit not actually accomplishing much in terms of disease prevention over what your skin already does. Of course, when a toilet containing fecal matter is flushed, it tends to result in the microbes and bits of said fecal matter being sprayed about, including landing on that latch handle you touched, as well as exposed bits of toilet paper, and yes, the exposed part of the disposable toilet seat liners, as well as the exposed bits of paper that you often use to dry your hands with once you've washed them. And look, I'm just gonna stop here because, let's face it, you probably don't want to know what happens when you use a hand dryer. It could be worse, though. In ancient Rome, a wet sponge and a stick was used for wiping. Now, that might actually sound quite comfortable and rather appealing until you learn that after being used, the sponge was placed back into a tub of salt water for the next person to come along and wipe with it. And look, even if that salt water was strong enough to kill off any microbes, I still want to say a big old ugh. So, I really hope you found that video disgusting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, if you're looking for something else to watch, why not check out my other channel? It's called Biographics. We do biographies of notable people from the present day as well as history. And as always, thank you for watching.